On this video, I'm going to talk about the macOS Mojave Beta 11, why you should stick with the Beta 10, what is the improvements that you'll find on this one, and what is the results that you'll find in Geekbench and Cinebench. So if you want to know everything, stay tuned after the intro. Hi everyone, welcome to MedPack, where we unpack your next product. And hey, if it's your first time here, don't forget to subscribe to this channel. On this channel, we only talk about technology, so if you like this type of content, I hope to see you in the next one. So let's talk a little bit more about the macOS Mojave Beta 11. I'll let you know something that I noticed different that I really like on the macOS Mojave Beta 11. But right now, let's talk a little bit more about the results that I get with the macOS Mojave Beta 11 compared to the macOS Mojave Beta 10. If it's your first time here, the computer that I have is a MacBook Pro Mid 2012. A Retina display with 8 GB of RAM. I know it's not the most recent computer that you have on the market, but I have to tell you guys that this is not important because every single person have a different computer, so the results will be different. But you can have an idea how it will work on your machine, okay? Because I've been covering them since the beginning, since they released the beta, so since the version 1, and now we are already in the version 11. So I think that I can give you a very good idea how it will work until they release the official version the 24th of September. So let's talk about the results that I get with this machine in Geekbench in OpenCL comparing the macOS Mojave Beta 10 compared to the Beta 11. So with the Beta 10 I had the score of 6,414, and when we talk about the macOS Mojave Beta 11 I get the score of 6,240. So the result is a negative result of minus 2.7%, and that is the first negative results that I get with this new version. When we talk about Geekbench in single score with the macOS Mojave Beta 10, I get the result of 3,492. And when we pass to the macOS Mojave Beta 11, I get 3,532. And that is an improvement of 1.15%. But I lost almost 3% in OpenGL, so until now I have to tell you guys that is a negative result. But let's continue to the next one, and the next one is the multi-score. So with the macOS Mojave Beta 10, I get a score of 11,964. And when we pass to the macOS Mojave Beta 11, 11,392. And that is once again a negative result of 4.78%. So I even tried more than one time and I was always getting negative results. So in the end, OpenGL is negative, multiscore is negative, and an improvement of 1.15% in single score, I was not really, really happy with the results that I get with a Geekbench. So when we talk about Cinebench in OpenGL with the macOS Mojave Beta 10, I ran 3 tests like I always do, and with the macOS Mojave Beta 10, the first score was 49.53 frames per second, the second one 48.30 frames per second, and the last one 47.69 frames per second. That gives us an average of 48.50 frames per second. When we talk about the macOS Mojave Beta 11, the first score was 49.72 frames per second, the second one 48.36 frames per second, and the last one 47.97 frames per second. That gives us an average of 48.68 frames per second. So here is an improvement of 0.3%. So in the end of the day, the results are very, very similar between the macOS Mojave Beta 10 and the macOS Mojave Beta 11 in OpenGL. So let's see in CPU if we have improvements or not, more relevant than 0.3%. So when we talk about CPU in Cinebench, with the macOS Mojave Beta 10, I run 3 tests like I do always. So the first result was 545, the second one 548, and the last one 548 once again. That gives us an average of 547 CBs. When we jump to the macOS Mojave Beta 11, I ran 3 tests. The first one was 549, the second one 531, and the last one 537. That gives us an average of 539 CBs. And that is once again a negative result of 1.46%. So if you think about it, all the results that I get, they are similar, negative, and I have a positive result of 1.15% in single score on Geekbench. So if you don't have a upgrade until now, I recommend you to stick with the macOS Mojave Beta 10 and don't upgrade to the Beta 11. Before I show you something that I noticed difference with the macOS Mojave Beta 11, if you want to know a little bit more about the macOS Mojave, I recommend you to check the videos that I've done about the macOS Mojave since the Beta 5. So if you want to know a little bit more, I will leave in the cards and the description below. If you want to know all the features, if you never read anything about the macOS Mojave, I recommend you to check the video that I've done about the macOS Mojave Beta 1 and Beta 2. And if you want to install, I also leave in the cards and the description below. But let's talk about the change that you will find on the macOS Mojave Beta 11. And right now, maybe you are saying to me, Matt, you are getting mad. But I'm not. So basically, when I want to update anything on my computer, I have everything manually. Okay, so if it comes a new update to an app on my computer, I do that manually. And in this case, the Google Chrome, for example, I noticed that a new tab is a little bit more round around the edges. So that is a difference that I like to see there. And after I tried to open other apps that I have here, for example, like Visor, and I noticed that in Visor also on the corners is a little bit more round. Let me know in the comments below if you noticed that, but it's just to let you know that I noticed that change on the macOS Mojave Beta 11. Before I finish the video, I have to tell you guys that I'm a bit disappointed with this new version, with the macOS Mojave Beta 11, because the results that I get, they are inferior than the macOS Mojave Beta 10. So that is something that I was not expecting to see so close to the official version. I was expecting to see always something getting better. And in this case, majority gets worse. Just single scoring Geekbench is a little bit better, but it's also 1.15%. So it's not really relevant. And the other one was 0.3%. And all the other ones, they are negative. 4.78%. Question of the day, what do you think about the macOS Mojave Beta 11? Are you going to install on your computer or are you going to stick with the macOS Mojave Beta 10? Let me know in the comments below. Before you go, don't forget to subscribe to this channel if you don't have subscribed until now. Share this video with your family and friends. Comment below, smash the thumbs up. And like I said in all my videos, you already know the answer. I see you in the next one.